Hello students, in this session we will start with the continue statement in the Java. Okay, so in the previous session we learned about the break statement. So whenever you include the break statement in your program, the execution of the program will terminate. Means that if you include that break statement inside any for loop, the execution of that for loop will be terminated and control will come outside the for loop. So unlike the break which causes the loop to be terminated, the continue causes the loop to be continued with the next iteration. Suppose that you have a for loop. So inside that for loop, you have a condition statement. Okay, assume that the conditional statement. Inside that conditional statement, that is if condition, you have continue statement. Okay, your for loop starts its execution. Next, the control will come to the if condition. If that condition satisfied, after that condition we include a continue statement. If that condition satisfied, we have continue statement. Okay, so it means that again the iteration of that for loop will start. So whenever that if condition satisfied, again the for loop iteration will begin from the starting. Okay, the continue statement tells the compiler skip the following statement and continue the next iteration. Suppose that after the continue statement, you will be having some set of statement. The execution of that statement will be exempted. Okay, again the iteration will start from the beginning of the loop. So here you can take the example of while loop. So while condition. So inside this while loop, again we have a if condition. Okay, if this condition is satisfied, after that we have continue statement. If this condition is evaluated to true, next it will execute the continue statement. So if this continue statement is nothing but again the control is transferred to the while loop. So again the control is transferred to while loop and the execution of the followed statement will be exempted. This following statement will not be executed. So this is with respect to the while loop. Suppose that you have a do while loop. Okay, so execution start from the do. Again that we here we have a if condition. If this condition is evaluated to true, followed by that we have a continue statement. It means that so again it will start with the while condition. If this condition satisfied, so control will be transferred to do while. So again it will check for the condition. If this condition satisfied, again the control will be transferred to the while loop. So this process will repeat until this condition satisfied. So for for loop also you can include this continue statement. If this condition is evaluated to true, then the continue statement will be executed. It means that so compiler will again start from the execution of for loop and followed statements will not be executed. Okay, so this is about the continue statement. So next we will see a simple program for the continue statement. So in this continue statement, it means that whenever you include the continue statement, that continue statement will again start the execution of next iteration. So in this program, so we are checking whether the given whether the number is even or odd. If the number is even, we are not printing that value. So we are again continue with the next iteration. So here we created a class called continue demo. Okay, so inside that main method we created a for loop for int I equal to 0, I less than 10 and I plus plus. So here we are displaying the odd numbers between 0 to 10. Okay, so inside this for loop we have a condition if I percentage 2 equal to 0. So it means that whenever the I is even, okay, whenever the I is even, we are skipping the execution. So this continue means the control will be again transferred to for loop. So here initially consider I is 0. So 0 mod 2 equal to so just make it as 1. So assume that I is 1. I mod 2 1 mod 2 equal to 0. No. So this condition fails. Next, we display that number. That is the odd number. Next, increment the I value. Now I is 2. So 2 mod 2 equal to 0. The condition satisfied. Okay. So it will continue with the next iteration. Now I value is incremented. Now I is 3. So 3 is less than 10. Condition satisfied. And 3 mod 2 equal to 0. Okay. So this condition will not satisfy. Next, display that odd number. So this is a simple program for printing the odd numbers. So whenever the given number, that is I, is even, we are skipping the execution. Okay. So we try to execute the same program using Eclipse IDE. So here we will create a class. Right click, new class. So we name it as a so we require the main method and click on finish. To follow for I equal to 0. I, so first we make it as I equal to 1 and I less than I less than 10 and I plus plus. So here we need to check whether it is even or odd. I modulus operator 2 equal to 0 means that it is even. So whenever it is even, so we need to include continue statement. Okay, if that is not even, so we need to display that number. System dot out dot print. Okay, so this is a simple program. So where we are displaying the all odd numbers. If the number is even, we need to say that continue. Again, the execution start from the for loop. So try to execute this. So it will display all the numbers. So it's odd. Odd number 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So I will make it as a not equal to 0, and the same program can be modified for displaying the even number. Okay, so save this program and click on run. So your numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so this is the simple programmatical demonstration of continue statement. So whenever whenever the control comes for the continue, again it will start from the execution of loop. It will try for the next iteration. Okay, thank you, students.